Hello friends, today I am going to explain the properties of rational numbers. The properties of rational numbers are: the first property is the closure property, second property is commutative property, third is the associative property, fourth is the additive identity, fifth is the multiplicative identity, sixth is the additive inverse, seventh is the multiplicative inverse, 8th is the distributive property of multiplication over addition and subtraction. First, I explain closure property. Closure property we have to test for addition, subtraction, multiplication and division all. In addition, first we test for addition. Sum of any two rational numbers is always a rational number. Then subtraction, difference of any two rational numbers is always a rational number. In multiplication, product of any two rational numbers is always a rational number. But in division, the closure property is not fit because division by zero is not defined. So closure property is not true for division. Then we have to see commutative property. Commutative property also we have to test for all addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. In addition, if we change the order of the rational numbers, then their sum will not change. Change the order means if you put at the first place second rational number and second rational number at first place, then their sum will be the same. But in subtraction, the commutative property is not true. If you change the order of the rational numbers during subtraction, then their result will be changed, their difference will be changed. Then in multiplication, commutative property is true. In multiplication, if you change the order of the rational numbers, then their product will remain the same. But in division, commutative property is not true. If you change the order of the rational numbers in division, then their answers will not be same. Their questions will not be same. Then we have to check the associative property. In associative property, we have to take three rational numbers always. In three rational numbers, if we make grouping of rational numbers, the first two rational numbers in one group or the last two numbers in one group, then in addition, if you change the grouping of rational numbers, then their sum also remains same. But in subtraction, if you change the grouping of rational numbers, then it will not be true. The result will be changed. The difference will be changed. But in multiplication, the associative property is true. If you change the grouping of rational numbers, then their product remains the same. But in division, associative property is not true. If you change the grouping of rational numbers in division, then their answers will not be same. So associative property is not true for division. So associative property is true only for addition and multiplication. Then we have to see the additive identity. Additive identity. Zero is the additive identity of rational numbers. If you add zero to any rational number, we get the same rational numbers. For example, 1 upon 2 plus 0, we get 1 upon 2. Then we have to see the multiplicative identity. Number 1 is the multiplicative identity of rational numbers. If you multiply 1 with any rational number, then you get same rational number, like 3 upon 2 multiplied by 1 equal to 3 upon 2. Now we have to see additive inverse. Additive inverse is a number, or you can say negative of a rational number is called its additive inverse. Means sum of rational number and its additive inverse is always zero. For example, 1 upon 2 plus minus 1 upon 2 equal to 0. So we say that minus 1 upon 2 is the additive inverse of 1 upon 2. Or if you take minus 3 upon 5 as a rational number, then its additive inverse will be positive 3 upon 5, because if you add minus 3 upon 5 and positive 3 upon 5, you will get 0. So sum of a rational number and its additive inverse is always 0. Then we have to see the multiplicative inverse. Multiplicative inverse, the product of a rational number and its multiplicative inverse is always 1. For example, 3 upon 7 multiplied by 7 upon 3 equal to 1. So 7 upon 3 is the multiplicative inverse of 3 upon 7, or you can say 3 upon 7 is the multiplicative inverse of 7 upon 3, because their product will be always 1. Then we have the distributive property of multiplication over addition and subtraction. Distributive property of multiplication over addition and subtraction, in this both the operations will be there. Like for distributive property for multiplication over addition, there will be multiplication as well as addition, and in subtraction there will be multiplication as well as subtraction. It is true for both. This is the multiplication over addition and multiplication over subtraction. This I'll explain in detail in my next video. Thank you. I hope you enjoy the video. Please share and subscribe my channel. Press the bell icon so you'll get all updates of my videos. Thank you.